Hello friends, welcome back. In the last video session, we have seen web service best practice and validation techniques, but we are not able to complete fully the validation techniques. We have done, but we are not able to provide a perfect message to customer. Whenever you input invalid or if you forgot to input some mandatory attribute, server return an error. That error not a readable, it's a technical error only. It's provided only technical error. The technical errors not understand by consumer. We have to think always about a consumer. Okay, we should not throw any technical error. The technical error cannot understand by a consumer. Now we need to customize the error. We need to send proper error to the customer. So this is the error we are getting, right? The last time internal server error 500, but this is not a correct error. When I miss some attribute, it gives this error. Now I want to provide valid error to the customer. For that, in the Spring framework, we have a one class called response entity exception handler. That class handling the all error message, providing the error to the REST client, providing the error to the client. Okay, whatever errors coming, these errors are handled here and throw that error to the client side. Now we need to customize this particular class in our own. Let's see how to do that. In this method, handle method argument invalid, not valid argument, not this method we need to customize. Okay, we need to override this method. That's the reason I am extending this particular class from my own class, stock management exception handler is our application specific exception class. That class extending from this particular response entity exception handler. Now I want to whatever method I want to customize, I can override here, I can customize. Then this class must be annotated with risk controller and a controller advice. This class act as a controller because return a response. Then this is a controller advice. The use of this particular annotation is I will going to implement the exception handling validation handling is centralized, not for each and every controller. In every project can have a lot of controller class, right? There will be for example today I have created a stock management controller. This stock handled by some user. So tomorrow I will going to create one more controller called user controller. Then after that I will going to handle an order controller. There will be a multiple controller class will come. I need to handle exception handling and a validation message in generic way. Okay, that if you want to handle generic way, controller advice is a very useful annotation that will going to take care of our exception handling in generic. Okay, let's see how to do that. Now as I mentioned here, what is that class handle? Sorry, what is that method? Handle method argument not valid. Just to copy this method. Copy this method and override here. Okay. Now we need to I want to create one more class under exception. It's a validation message. Validation, I'm not handling exception. Now I want to validate the each web service attribute. If anything goes wrong, I want to provide a message to the end user. So I'm validating the web service attribute. That is the reason I'm keeping the name as a validation message. Okay, for exception handling we can create another class called error message. Okay, now I want to tell some attribute here. In string message string message. Okay, validation message, validation message, then private int validation code, validation code, private timestamp. Okay, now I have created a three attribute in this validation message. One is a validation message, one is a validation message, and a validation code and a timestamp. I want to customize my error handling. Whenever throw some error, that error structure should be like this. That validation message should have a proper error message. Each error message I want to assign some error code, validation code. That code will be available in the validation code. Then timestamp. What time that particular validation happened? That time I want to track. For that reason, I'm using a timestamp. Then I want to create one constructor for this class validation message. String validation message int validation code timestamp this dot validation message equal to validation message this dot validation code equal to validation code this dot timestamp equal to timestamp. Then I'll create some setter and getter. Okay, done. Now my application error will be the following structure. Validation error will be the following structure. Always, whenever consumer made a mistake, the error will thrown in this format only. Through this object, I'll going to throw the error. Okay. Before that, I want to do one thing. I forgot to say, don't forget to add this dependency. If you want to perform validation, we have to add this starter project. As I mentioned initial class, Spring Boot provide lot of starter class. Each starter class doing particular functionality. Okay, for example, Spring Boot starter web for creating a web application, creating a RESTful web services. First, Spring Boot starter data JPA for handling a database. This is for validation is to handle validations. Okay, as of now, the current Spring Boot version is 2.3.1. From this version, they are providing separate starter project for validation. The previous version will come part of web app itself. You don't have to include. If you are using lower version of this, for example, if you are using 2.2 or some other version, we don't have to include the starter project, I believe. But I have not tested, but I saw some documentation. Through that I am understand that the Spring Boot 2.3.1 onwards, we need to provide separate starter project for validation message. Previous version we don't have to include that, because this part available part of web. Okay, this thing I want to tell you. Okay, don't forget to add that annotation and add the dependency, otherwise will not work. That is the one. Second one is, go to the controller. In the controller, we need to add one annotation. At valid. At valid. Okay, at valid. If you say at valid, through this annotation, whatever request coming from the client side, according to this particular endpoint, client sending them product information form of product object, that is form of in this manner, right? This is a product request body. Whenever come that product information, this valid will validate that attribute. Okay, this is also mandatory. The first point is we need to add this dependency. Second point is we need to add one annotation called at valid. Until add this dependency, you never get this valid. Once you add the dependency, then only you this particular annotation visible here. Okay, we have done whatever we need. After that, we have to customize this particular method. How to customize this? Now, what I did, 1 minute, I removed here something, right? Validation message equal to new validation message. The first argument I need to pass a timestamp. Okay. Private get current time. Timestamp. Calendar dot get instance dot get times milli timestamp equal to new timestamp. New timestamp return timestamp. That's it. I want to create a private method returning a current timestamp because a lot of places will going to use this. That's the reason I'm creating a private method get current timestamp. Then I want to add a what is that validation code. Just as of now, I'm going to hard code this validation code. Then the last argument is a timestamp. Sorry. Then first argument is a error message. Just I want to get this error message. Ex dot get message. Okay. Now I want to pop this message here. Validation message 101, we have handled everything. Validation message handled validation. So I don't want to use this. Is written by the string framework. I want to return response entity, new response entity, validation message, comma, HTTP status code equal to bad request. That's it. Because we are validating the method, request body attribute. Any request body is invalid, that is a bad request, right? That is the reason I am sending status code as a bad request, okay? Then I am passing the validation message. Whenever user input invalid data or they forgot to miss, this method will automatically fired by spring framework. Handle method argument not valid. Okay. Why? Because I am saying here do validate. Through this annotation, I am saying validate this product attributes. Whenever I add this tag, since I add this tag, this particular method get invoke and validate those attributes. If anything missed, what will happen? This particular class get initialized. I'm getting the message from the I'm getting the validation message from this class and passing as a first argument and passing my own error code and passing current time date and time. Then I'm sending as a response that validation message with the bad request. Okay, let's see what's happening now. Don't forget to put these two annotation at controller advice at rest controller. Controller advice for handling all the controller in your application. Okay. Now I'm going to start my application. Yeah, application started. Now I'm going to send this attribute. One attribute is missing. That stock count is missing. Let's see what's the error is coming now. See, now we're going to get a different message. Validation message is an attribute. Where is this attribute? We have created one class, right? Validation message. This is a validation message that is coming here. Validation code. The validation code is a 101. Timestamp. Timestamp is a current date and time. So I'm using this particular attribute in the stock management exception handler. So whatever message coming here, I am taking that message, passing the validation message constructor and passing my own error code, then current timestamp. Now this object I am passing as the response validation message by response entity, that value coming here. See here, this coming some messages, lot of messages coming. Finally, when you look at here, product stock count cannot be empty. This message, whatever message I have given in the product attribute, in the stock count, right? Yeah. See, not null. Whenever it's a null, I want to display this message. Product stock count cannot be empty. This message is coming. Along with this message, I am getting some other error also. Okay, now we have improved something. We at least are going to get whatever message we are expecting. Then we are giving some error code and the timestamp. Okay, now we're going to see how to eliminate other errors. Where is that? Yeah. There is a one method called get binding results. This is having all the messages, right? Messages. Okay, so we want to extract only whatever error we want to display to the client. That is my goal now. Okay, there are a lot of methods available here. Get all errors, list object error. Object error equal to, I don't want to give list, I want to give object errors. Okay, now I'm going to iterate this one for each. There is one method called default message. I want to add this message in my own list. I'll going to create a one list object here, list string validation messages equal to new array list. String validation message, sorry, string default message equal to validation messages, sorry, validation messages dot add validation message, sorry, default message. Okay, now this get all error, what you will do, it returning all the error, that errors binded with object error. So the get all error return list of object error. Object error having a multiple errors, whatever, let's see the response, whatever seeing, right? This information available here, but I want to get only this particular message. This is called as default message. I want to get that message alone. Okay, in this method there is one method called, in this object there is one method called get default message. Using that I can get this particular method. I am adding that message in my list object, in my list object. Then what I want to do is here, then what I want to do here, okay, here, put here. In this object, I want to pass this particular array list dot to array or to string, whatever. Okay. Now I'll going to extracting the particular message which I want to display to the end user and passing that list in my I want to pass here. I want to pause here. I want to pause this object here. Sorry. Okay. I'll explain once again. I created a new array list called validation messages. Then from the this particular object is binding all the errors. There is a one class called one method called get bind result that return all the errors. This returns a collection array list. Okay. Array list. I want to the array list. We need to iterate this array list. Each iteration will going to get the object error. The object error, I want to get only the message which I want to display to the customer. that message is available inside default message. Okay, using default message method, I am getting that message. I am adding that message to in my array list. In my array list, now after execution of this particular code, the validation message will have only the message which I want to show. After that, I am initializing the validation message class which we created. The first argument, I am converting this list as a two string and passing it to the first argument. The second argument, the error code 101 I am passing. Third argument, I am passing the current time, date and time. Okay, then I am passing this object as a response object in my response entity. Okay, now I will going to start my application. Started the application. Now I will go to send a request. See here, validation message. Product stock count cannot be empty. I have not added the product stock. That is the reason I am getting that particular error. Product stock is cannot be empty. Validation code 1. Timestamp equal to current date and time. Okay, now I am going to remove one more attribute from here. Let's see what's going on, what's happening. I am getting product price cannot be empty. Product stock count cannot be empty. I'll going to remove also this. Let's say I'll going to get three attributes is a mandatory. Now I'll going to add product stock count equal to 10. Product stock count, still it says product stock count cannot be empty. Why? Why this is saying like this? Still product stock count cannot be empty. What I did in the product? Not null, product stock count cannot be empty. It's an integer object, null only I'm passing. Product stock count. Oh, here is a spelling mistake. Product stock count I give. Sorry. We need to pass the correct attribute. Now I am going to say. See. Status created. My object is creating database. Let's see the database now. Okay, I'll connect and see now. 1, Apple 30 and 20. Now it's created. I hope you people are understand the how to perform the validation. If still you are not clear, please ask question in the comment section. Definitely I will going to clarify. Okay, in the next video session we will going to see how to do the exception handling, how to do the generic exception handling. Okay, please subscribe if you are not yet. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thank you so much for watching this full video. Until next video, bye bye from Suresh K7.